finally, one more thought. Seeing is believing. So said 17th century clergyman Thomas Fuller. But in the age of generative AI, seeing may not be all that it was once cracked up to be. Something Donald Trump Jr. showed us with a Dr. Deepfake version of The Office that had presidential candidate Ron DeSantis embarrassed that he'd bought a women's suit.
Make one tiny mistake, you're dead. I made one tiny mistake. I wore women's clothes.
And it's not just our eyes that AI has made us come to doubt, it's our ears as well. Not to be outdone by his own son, Donald Trump Sr., that's the former president himself, posted on Instagram his own deepfake audio that purported to be a conversation including Elon Musk, Mr. DeSantis, George Soros, and the devil himself.
I don't think George knows how to use Twitter.
And lest you think that it's only Republicans who are using AI to alter media reality, consider the case of the Democratic senator from Connecticut, Richard Blumenthal, who, as the chair of the Senate Judiciary Committee, recently started a hearing about regulating ChatGPT by opening the remarks generated by, you guessed it, ChatGPT itself.
We have seen how algorithmic biases can perpetuate discrimination and prejudice.
The words were not mine, and the audio was an AI voice cloning software trained on my floor speeches.
But let's be honest, none of us was going to be fooled by any of all that. Which is more than you can say for the New York lawyer recently caught red-handed, submitting a 10-page brief to the court opposing a motion to dismiss, complete with multiple citations of cases he quoted that seemed just right on point. Unfortunately, neither the judge nor opposing counsel could find the cases that he cited. It turned out that the lawyer had relied on ChatGPT, which had simply made it all up. Not exactly what we lawyers had in mind when we pledged to become officers of the court.
I will maintain the confidence and preserve inviolate the secrets of my client.
But never fear, at least we have the news media to make sure we're always getting the straight story. Provided, of course, that you're getting it from the journalist and not from his own avatar.
Joining us now is a very special, slightly weird guest. It is, in fact, my own digital avatar.
Avatars have the power to enhance user experiences, enabling immersive virtual interactions and personalized content. They can facilitate remote collaboration, telepresence, and even assist with customer service.